Good evening, I'm Greg Phillips, next on Fox 6 News. A mother of a two-year-old shot to death in a drive-by shooting. Tonight, the clues that can help catch her killer on San Diego's Most Wanted. Drinking south of the border. Find out why cops are out in full force looking for you when you come back. Two Navy ships return from the Middle East. It's an emotional return for some homesick sailors. And we're in Peoria as the Padres start spring training. Fox 6 News starts right now.
This is Fox 6 News.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm Greg Phillips.
Hi, everyone. I'm Kelly Kraft. It's a huge problem in Southern California, teens crossing the border to drink. Now, there has been a drop in the number of DUI-related deaths recently, but tonight, officers from several different agencies are out in force, set on eliminating the problem altogether. Fox 6 News reporter Desiree Carbajal is live in South San Diego with the latest. Desiree, what's the reason for the drop in all these numbers?
Well, Kelly, basically it comes down to commitment and cooperation. Several law enforcement agencies from around the area are getting together tonight. They're going to be heavily patrolling the area near the border. The whole point is to get drunk drivers off the street. You're probably used to seeing some of those sobriety checkpoints scattered throughout the area. This is a whole different deal. There won't be that many checkpoints, but definitely police presence will be everywhere.
An average of 45,000 cars come into the U.S. from Mexico every weekend.
It is the world's busiest international border crossing.
And an average of 12,000 pedestrians also make their way across.
And potentially a lot of people who may be impaired coming back across the border later in the evening.
As night begins to fall, a lot of people drive back home drunk. Others walk back, get into their parked cars. You only hear about it when they kill someone.
We obviously don't want them to get behind the wheel of their car in the first place. That's the basis for this entire operation.
Officers have already been patrolling streets, highways, and parking lots hoping to stop drunk drivers. It was part of a program called Operation Border Crossing.
We saw a phenomenal drop in the number of DUI-related fatalities just for San Diego CHP investigated only. In 1999, we had 23. In 2000, we had 4.
They're hoping this new cooperation will have even bigger results.
Now, as officers begin to arrest potential drunk drivers throughout the night, they are going to bring them here to the Sheriff's Department in South San Diego and into the trailer behind me. Now, what they have there are breathalyzer tests and blood tests that do hold up in court. They will be doing a lot of that throughout the night. And this sweep will continue till about 4 or 5 in the morning. Reporting live in South San Diego, Desiree Carvajal, Fox 6 News.
Desiree, thank you very much. Now we'd like to get your opinion. Do you believe DUI checkpoints serve as a deterrent to drinking and driving? Log on to our website at www.fox6.com. Let us know what you think. We'll have the results for you later on in the newscast. A gardener discovers a woman's dead body outside a blood bank in Vista, and now police need your help to identify her. Authorities believe the woman was killed somewhere else and then dumped here in the bushes. They say she had a cut on her chin and foot, but don't know what killed her. Police say the woman is white, between 25 and 30 years old, weighing between 115 and 120 pounds, with dyed blonde hair. She was wearing a white blouse, dark pants, but no shoes. If you have any information, call the Vista Sheriff's Communications Center, that number 858-467-4400. Officers shot and killed a man who was threatening suicide earlier this afternoon. Police say when they arrived at this Chula Vista home, a 40-year-old man came out of the house armed with several knives. They ordered the man to drop them, but he didn't. A police spokesperson told Fox 6 the man may have charged at the officers. An investigation is underway. Some frightening moments for 4 people trapped under a collapsed rooftop this evening. Crews say it happened around 5 o'clock at 3rd and Orange Avenues in Chula Vista. Firefighters and some Good Samaritans worked together to pull 2 children and 2 adults from the debris. Each were taken to local hospitals with non-threatening injuries. City inspectors still don't know what caused the collapse. The area is now closed to traffic.
Just a day after President Bush orders military strikes in Iraq, hundreds of sailors return home from a 6-month deployment to the Persian Gulf. Fox 6 News reporter Nancy Aziz was there as the USS Bunker Hill and the USS Shiloh made it into port.
Is it a ship? cruise ship?
The USS Bunker Hill, just a few hundred yards away from port.
What are you going through?
A lot of butterflies in my stomach.
Really excited.
So close.
Where's Daddy?
Yet so far away, especially when you're nine.
Where do they sleep?
And Dad's been at sea for months.
I can't wait to see my dad.
Caleb Dark's dad is aboard the USS Bunker Hill with about 350 other sailors. The Bunker Hill and the USS Shiloh are just returning from a six-month deployment in the world's hotbed, the Persian Gulf. The ships protected the USS Cole after the attack and helped enforce UN sanctions against Iraq. But dangerous duty worries those left at home.
We just have to keep praying that he'll come home safe.
When he does, Dark's family has so much to say.
I love you.
And so much to do.
Just can't wait to see his face again and hug him.
Give him a big hug.
Now the wait is finally over.
He's coming home.
What's up, man? How you been?
Good.
Nancy Aziz, Fox 6 News.
Well, the timing of the sailors' return couldn't be better for their families. With the U.S. bombing of Baghdad, Navy families say they're especially glad their loved ones are back safely and out of the dangerous region. Both the USS Shiloh and the USS Bunker Hill helped monitor ships in the Persian Gulf, enforcing the UN-imposed sanctions.
Iraq continues to push the edge of that envelope, trying to get away with as much as they can, and it's important that we hold those sanctions.
Despite the danger, sailors say they're ready to go back when and if they need to. A local congressional leader says yesterday's airstrikes in Iraq send a clear message to Saddam Hussein. The new administration won't tolerate a threat to U.S. security. Randy Duke Cunningham says in recent months, the Iraqi dictator has fired a number of missiles at U.S. and British pilots, violating the no-fly zone.
Saddam Hussein was warned. He rejected our warning. And the only prudent thing to do was to take out those radar sites before we lost American lives or British lives.
Cunningham says the strikes were required without warning because, he says, Hussein is known to put women and children in front of targets he believes his enemies may fire at.
It's tax time again, and we all know what that means. Well, this year, someone wants to make filing your tax return a little bit easier. Students at Thomas Jefferson Law School are offering tax assistance for anyone who files a 1040A or 1040EZ, and best part, it's free.
This is primarily for people who would be very much hurt by having to pay $200 to $300 to get their returns prepared. And so we do this primarily for low-income people and for people who have the most basic types of returns.
If you're interested, log on to fox6.com and click on Tax Time, and we'll tell you how to take advantage of this free service. Well, all the hot real estate properties in San Diego can now be seen by just the click of a mouse. E-Real Estate Company lets you browse an extensive list of homes that are on the market. The company's CEO says it's convenient and cost-efficient, so if you're looking for a new home or just want to check out what's out there, log on to fox6.com and we'll click you on online home buyers, and then that will link you to the site.
Could save you a little time, too.
It really could.
All right. Well, an innocent bystander falls victim to indiscriminate gang violence. Still ahead on Fox 6 News, help police catch the killers of a young mother on this week's edition of San Diego's Most Wanted.
Plus, a one-on-one interview with the man behind America's Most Wanted. Hear what he has to say about keeping your kids safe.
And care for a condom with your alcoholic beverage? It could soon be the law in one California city. We'll explain.
And despite the cloud cover today, we're pretty warm here in San Diego County for the most part, up a couple of degrees. Let's see what we did. 67 degrees the high in downtown. Overnight low of 50. That was warm, insulated by some of that cloud cover that rolled in on the overnight. There's your sunrise and the sunset. The air quality was pretty decent here in town today. Stick around. Your Fox 6 Day forecast is right around the corner.
You're watching Fox 6 News with Greg Phillips, Kelly Kraft, Katie Temple with sports, and Chris Salcedo's weather. This is Fox 6 News at 10.
Chrysler and Jeep vehicles continue to receive more and more and more awards. And now it's time to reward you with the Chrysler and Jeep Rewards Program. Now for a limited time, get 0.9% APR financing on select Chrysler and Jeep vehicles. Reward yourself today with one of our award winners. And that's better than carrying around any trophy.
Introducing Rincon Casino at Valley Center. San Diego's first all-Vegas-style slot casino. The new Rincon Casino at Valley Center. It's a slot player's paradise.
No. I saw her. She was shaved.
An Irish setter with hair like hers? Shameful.
Well, you didn't hear it from me. But I heard she had fleas.
Oh, my goodness.
Don't dogs use Advantage?
Since I was a pup his age.
I use it every month, and I've yet to see a flea.
It's never too early to be flea-free.
Ask your veterinarian for Advantage now. Don't give fleas a biting chance.
What's a flea?
She was the mother of a two-year-old, and she was caught in the crossfire of gang violence. Tonight, you can help police put those responsible behind bars. Here's Officer Jim Johnson with this week's edition of San Diego's Most Wanted.
September 4th, 1993. It's 3:45 in the morning. A group of young men and women are standing on the sidewalk in the 1600 block of 39th Street. The Shelltown community is quiet, with just the soft voices of friends saying goodnight. Out of the darkness, a white minivan occupied by a Logan Heights gang travels down Gamma Street. As it approaches 39th Street, it slows to a stop. A 17-year-old girl is struck in the leg as the van speeds off. Not realizing what had just happened, 21-year-old Mimi Barraza, a mother of a 2-year-old baby girl, had just moved her car to the south alley of Gamma Street. The gang, not satisfied with the first round of firing, plans an immediate second attack. The van, now circling around the block and traveling down Delta Street, stops as it approaches 39th Street. Just as Mimi walks out of the alley onto 39th Street, the van doors fly open and unleash a new volley of bullets. Mimi was struck by a bullet from the assault rifle and died at the scene. The van sped off and was never seen again.
Here's a number to call if you have any information. 619-235-TIPS. Crime Stopper staff is standing by right now to take your call. You can remain anonymous and earn up to a $1,000 reward. That number again, 619-235-TIPS. Last year, the Justice Department says there were close to 5,000 attempted child abductions. Experts say the reason those children got away is because they knew how to handle the situation. We had a chance to sit down with John Walsh. He's the host of America's Most Wanted, and he says many abductions take place when strangers ask children to come to their cars.
When a guy pulls up, a stranger pulls up and says, "I'm lost, I need directions," or "help me look for my puppy," no, you don't go near that car. You tell adults get help from other adults. They don't need help from kids.
For more information on how to keep children safe, call 1-800-THE-LOST.
Well, it's been a benchmark of student achievement for years, but now the president of the University of California says he wants to eliminate the SAT test as an entrance requirement. President Richard Atkinson says the SAT is unfair and doesn't adequately measure how much a student has really learned. He suggests an approach that doesn't only look at test scores, but the students' overall achievements. 12% of California's college-bound seniors took the test last year. Well, the next time you visit a bar in West Hollywood, don't be surprised if you get a condom along with that beer or martini. The condom could come courtesy of a new proposed law. Proposition A would require bars and businesses that serve alcohol to distribute contraceptives to customers. A former Playboy playmate who supports Prop A and is also HIV positive says the law is not just for men.
Women, unfortunately, still don't consider themselves at risk for contracting HIV. Unfortunately, when in all reality, they are 10 times more likely to become infected than a man is.
Opponents of Proposition A say if passed, it would cost close to $200,000 a year to enforce, and it would create an adversarial relationship between bars and restaurants in the city, many of which already provide free condoms to customers.
Wow.
Yeah. Hmm. Wow, that was my reaction, too.
How about
they
that?
They take a lot of businesses away from 7-Elevens or something, huh?
You got to think so. 7-Elevens straight up. That's something I didn't think about, yeah. Katie.
You should know. You tell me.
No.
What did I
all
do
right,
to
all right, all right, all right. Time out. You know, there's another kind of rubber in sports, talking about the pitching mound. And the Padres are getting busy at spring training. We'll hear from the players, including number 19, T. Gwen. Plus, highlights from local college hoops teams. Find out if the Toreros can steal the thunder away from USF when sports comes right back.
And what's a sports segment without a little blood thrown in for good measure? Stick around. We'll tell you how a day dedicated to collecting it turned out.
This is a waiting room where Jesus is the doctor.
Doctors charge a fee, Jesus heals for free.
Is what they preach. Good medical practice.
I've watched people instantly heal.
Meet people who believe.
It's a way of life, it's a way of thinking.
Doctors who doubt.
I know of 300 children who have died.
Faith healers. Tomorrow at 10 after the X-Files, only on Fox 6 News.
Your Dodge dealer is fired up about our return to Daytona. He's offering some tremendous deals during the Countdown to Daytona sales event. More people have switched to Dodge trucks, and now even more will switch to Dodge Ram thanks to low 0.9% financing. Dodge is back at Daytona, and your Dodge dealers are behind this thing all the way.
Finished camshafts and lightweight pistons mean less friction. Less friction means more power. More power means suddenly the speed of light doesn't seem so fast anymore. The Infiniti i30. It's all the best thinking.
Who is the father of Scully's baby?
There's something I haven't told you.
I don't believe this.
The X-Files.
All new tomorrow at 9 on Fox 6.
Why is our house the newest teen hangout? Because we just got that really fast internet service. Because we have over 240 channels and a second phone line. Because we got everything in one simple package that only Cox offers.
Now get digital cable, high-speed internet, and local and long-distance phone service together in one affordable package from Cox.
Save $10 a month every month when you have the Cox Combo. Call today to find out how to get free activation of Cox Digital Cable.
Cox Communications. Now you're living.
When you need help, call someone you can trust. Call King Stallman Bail Bonds. Over 50 years of experience. 1-800-782-4522. Hablamos Español.
If you need a bail bondsman, look for this ad in your Yellow Pages.
A San Diego lawyer earns millions filing lawsuits on your behalf. Is he fighting for justice?
Just forget it. Okay, we'll litigate a while.
Or is he just using the system? A class action after Ellie McBeal, Monday at 10 on Fox 6 News.
Well, it was a total K-Day in North County. The Kiwanis Clubs dedicated the day to giving the gift of life. Blood is needed badly right now, so the club set out to give back to the community by setting up large-scale blood drives at blood banks all over North County. Another Kiwanis-sponsored drive will be held tomorrow at the Major Market grocery store in Fallbrook.
This is Fox 6 Sports with Katie Temple.
After a six-knee operation and a soap opera disguised as a contract negotiation in the offseason, Tony Gwynn starts his 20th spring training with the Padres. The eight-time NL batting champ taking cuts today in Peoria. Of course, the big issue will be Gwynn's health. Number 19's just hoping to see more playing time than he did last season.
As long as I feel good and as long as I'm productive, I'll get plenty of opportunities to play, I think. It's just going to be how my knee reacts, and you know, so you're kind of cautiously optimistic that everything's going to work out, but I really don't know.
Gwynn is one of many position players joining pitchers and catchers today for their first official day of workouts at the Padres spring training home in Peoria. Hey, it's been a long winter. These guys are just dying to get back on the diamond.
a great feeling just to hear the crack of the bat again and the smell of the grass. You know, it's what baseball is all about.
It's great to see the your players, your new faces, get back out here on the field. You've had your off season, so I just think they enjoy getting back out here doing what they love to do.
I got all new stuff. It's, you know, part of coming to a new team. Locker full of new goodies.
Get back out there, baby.
I just love playing the game of baseball. And to be able to have an opportunity to play in the big leagues is just, a great thing for me, to be able to fulfill my dreams.
Spring training is spring training. You know, it's a chance to, you know, get your work in. It's a chance for the fans to be up close and kind of see what we do. I think we all love doing it. I mean, in my case, I wouldn't be here if I didn't still enjoy doing what I do. But for the most part, I think most guys are like that, and they look forward to getting here. And then about a week after you've been here, it's like, God, when do we get to go home? But, you know, but that's spring training.
We will load you up with more stuff from the Padres and Peoria tomorrow on Phillips' favorite show, That Sunday Sports Show. Plus, Daytona 500 coverage and trivia with the Goals Girl. It's your chance to win great prizes tomorrow night at 10:30, right after Fox 6 News. You know, with USD hosting the West Coast Conference Tournament, the Toreros are playing their last road game of the year tonight, of course, unless they get into the NCAA or NIT tournament. But in any case, tonight, Dana White and the Toreros visiting the University of San Francisco. Andre Laws picking pockets and cashing in for the Toreros. Solid first half for USD. Dana White finding Tyler Field, who then finds the basket. Field leads the Toreros with 15 points. USD a comfy lead at the half, but USF comes back. And how? Eugene Brown, oh man. Tie ball game in the final seconds of the game. Scott Boardman for three in the win. Yes, he drains it. USD wins 70-67. Steve Fisher and the Aztecs at the famous but not so friendly Pit in New Mexico. Aztecs, 20 turnovers, and Reuben Douglas taking advantage. Douglas with the game high, 22 points. Chris Walton flew into the hoop. Aztecs only down four at the half, but the Lobos are too tough. Waylon White, thanks for stopping by. New Mexico wins it 72-54. Pac-10 action, Steve Lavin and the Bruins looking for their fifth straight win. 23 turnovers for the Sun Devils. Look at the Bruins' ball movement. Matt Barnes cleans it up. UCLA 73-68 over ASU. Arizona visiting USC, big night for Gilbert Arenas. Besides the nice lay-in, he's 8 of 9 from the floor, fills it up for 27 points. And then his teammate Richard Jefferson just puts the icing on the cake. Arizona hands SC its worst home loss ever, 105-61. Big night in the Bay, number 2 Stanford at Cal. These guys hate each other. They're hating it more as Cal. Justin Davis making sure of that. This one never close. Casey Jacobson, the nice little hook, 18 points and the victory. Cal can't hang. Stanford wins big, 88-56. To golf, crowd favorite Joe Pesci at the Bob Hope Classic. Joe Durant shoots a 66 today, setting a PGA Tour 72-hole record of 29 under. Durant has a 5-shot lead. But check this out. Arnold Palmer becomes the first player to shoot his age at 71 in a regular tour event in 22 years. Couple scores for you. Goals win 3-2, and then the Aztec baseball team loses 9-1.
Not good. No. All right.
Joe
Thanks,
Pesci.
Katie.
Joe Pesci.
Nice seeing him.
Arnold
okay,
Palmer.
Okay. Well, give me the worst thing on a 3-day weekend. Okay.
You kind of look like him, too.
Thanks. What could be the worst thing? I guess rain, and there could be some around the corner. I'll let you know when it comes up. Let's get you outside first. Get you caught up in what's going on. 57 degrees the temperature outside. Winds out of the northwest, 6 miles per hour. There's your dew point. Humidity getting up there from where it was earlier this afternoon. Barometer is steady at 30.15 inches of mercury. Stick around, some high-flying weather action is coming up next.
Monday on Fox in the Morning. You remember him from the 80s. Come on, I know you do. Maybe you were even one of them yourself. Now we catch up with local breakdancers who are putting a new twist on these classic moves.
A new twist, and Ken Anderson has a few tricks up his sleeve to help you keep your ginger in check. You won't want to miss this.
Let me show you how this works.
Start off. And of course, Chef Jim White. You know him. You love him. He takes us on a spin through his kitchen to bring out the master chef in all of us. All the fun.
And dancing.
Starts at 6. You betcha.
I got mine at ECC. We got ours at ECC.
Get yours at ECC.
You can get it all. All types of Hondas. All kinds of gear. all the service to back it up. Escondido Cycle Center. Come and get it.
If you've got a business to run, Staples has everything you need at guaranteed low prices.
Uh-huh. We got to get that contract signed.
Sir, did you order the Kung Pao chicken?
Yeah, it's going to be a long night.
Get the HP 45A Inkjet 2-pack for $48.98. Unbeatable prices. Staples, yeah, we've got that.
The San Diego International Auto Show is happening this weekend at the San Diego Convention Center.
See the pages of Motor Trend come alive.
Hundreds of new 2001 model vehicles on display, plus your 2002 sneak previews and futuristic concept cars.
Check out the tricked out PT Cruiser display and the PT Cruiser limo.
Sunday is Kids Day, featuring fun with Legoland. All kids 12 and under get in free when accompanied by an adult.
Ride the trolley to the San Diego International Auto Show this weekend at the San Diego Convention Center.
See the Union Tribune for details.
Great American Race comes to Fox 6 tomorrow with the Daytona 500.
This is Fox 6 Weather with Chris Salcedo.
And as promised, the high-flying action. This is Greg Phillips over Otay Lakes jumping out of a perfectly good airplane. Oh, my. Yes, thumbs up, Gregory. Thumbs up. Notice the clouds in the sky. Notice the clouds in the sky and the cheeks hitting the wind. Whoa! My goodness. He is completely insane. Nothing I would do, nothing any sane person. That very good. I am so proud of Greg Phillips. That is so cool. I mean, my wife wouldn't let me do that to save my life, seriously. Here's what's going on in the country. It's basically quiet around most of the nation. Some lake effect snow falling up here in the Great Lakes region, and that big cold front that was hitting the East Coast yesterday moved out into the Atlantic is just fine. All the action out here on the West Coast. And our concerns stem from this area of moisture right here, big area of low pressure. Tail end of this is swinging down toward us, coupled with this southerly moisture we've been getting today. It gave us the cloud cover. This will reach us by Sunday early morning, I would say, late tonight, maybe early tomorrow morning, and then pass through quickly. This is what we're in store for Monday, and something you can't even see way out there in Pacific. Maybe by next Friday, a more significant storm moving in. Have a look at what this storm, which is primarily coming on board into the north of us, into Central California, Northern California, mixed precipitation and snow falling in the Sierras, and a lot of moisture, it looks like, out here off the coast of San Diego. It was 60% relative humidity earlier on this afternoon, up to 90%. So we could see a stray shower tonight into tomorrow morning, possibly. Tonight, mid-40s, two low 50s, and a 20% chance of rain in the valleys in the 40s there, and more significant chance of rain up in the mountain areas, mid-30s to mid-40s, and some windy conditions as well. Gusts up to 25 miles per hour. There's your high tide, low tide in the Fox 6 Seacast. There's a swell out of the west, 2 to 3 feet. Water temperature is 57 degrees, been that way for the last week or so. Tomorrow, in your part of town, in La Jolla, 63, 68 in El Cajon, 65 for La Mesa, 67 Loving Grove tomorrow. And
announcing Singular, the wireless company that believes in the value of self-expression.
It's the amazing stuffed crust pizza from Pizza Hut, the world's one and only pizza you eat backwards. Backwards is your shortcut to an incredible ooey-gooey cheese nirvana right inside the crust. And for a price as good backwards as forwards, just $9.99 for a large stuffed crust pizza. Eat it backwards.
Chrysler and Jeep vehicles continue to receive more and more and more awards. And now it's time to reward you with the Chrysler and Jeep Rewards Program. Now for a limited time, get 0.9% APR financing on select Chrysler and Jeep vehicles. Reward yourself today with one of our award winners. And that's better than carrying around any trophy.
I can't look. What's happening?
Well, right now, Crispy is...
Ooh, ew! Oh, mother!
Now would be the time to help me.
And they look so innocent.
Bad baby.
I made this.
Next Sunday,